Hey party people, I'm Captain Zeus and welcome back to BP Fun. In today's video, I'll be doing a review for episode 7 of the Suicide Squad Isekai anime. Now for those of you that have not seen the episode yet, spoiler warning, because I will be going into details about this episode. And don't forget to like and subscribe for more nerdy content like this. Click the bell to be notified whenever I post another review episode. Now, I will say this anime is just so good. It cannot be understated how good this series is. From a comedy, from the action, the art style, and just soundtrack as well. Overall, this series is just so good. We're gonna dive into this first part where Harley's kind of having a little flashback about Joker telling her the plan about breaking into the bank. And someone commented in one of the previous episodes where they did a similar situation where Harley kind of has a flashback about a similar situation the Suicide Squad are in to help them achieve their goal and overcome this hurdle. And it really puts the emphasis on the fact that Harley is a main focal point of this series and is more of a main character than the other Suicide Squad members. We kind of see that if it wasn't already prevalent in the first episode, where we're more following her story and we're getting backstory and flashbacks with her character instead of the others, which isn't necessarily an issue. She's a popular character. The way they're doing it in this show is also just fantastic. So it's really not that big of a deal. And then next we go into the part where Peacemaker shows off his freaking genius. Once again, it cannot be overstated the fact that they make him so smart in this. And maybe he's just that smart in the comics. I haven't read too much about him in the comics, but he is just so freaking intelligent in this episode and in this series in general. One thing I also want to point out is the fact that Clayface making a full replica of the fortress just out of the ground. I just think it's just hilarious. It's just adorable. I loved it. Everything about that was cool. And then we get into the actual plan. We have King Shark and Clayface infiltrating while Harley and Peacemaker go to the hut, and then Deadshot's on watch duty. I just love the fact that when Deadshot kicked Rig Flag off of the cliff, quite literally, like, it was such an anime moment, the way he bounced off of each of the rocks and whatnot. And that's something I noticed in this episode too, is there's a lot of anime moments in terms of facial features, the way certain characters react, just the goofiness of this show. Like, it's so freaking funny. And as an anime fan, as a DC fan, it's literally the best of both worlds. Also, I want to add here, the fact that when Peacemaker, like, took off his helmet and was showing off the fact that he's going to be, like, infiltrating as an elf, everyone was just, like, in awe. And I was like, is this guy, like, He-Man or something? Like, what is going on here? And speaking of Peacemaker, he interrogates, it's not even an interrogation at this point. He is torturing that poor elf guy, so that way their power, like the telepathy, connects to all the other ones with the pain that he's enduring. And man, Peacemaker looked like he was enjoying the crap out of himself. As we go into further into the episode, we see Harley fight the scientist. Can't remember the guy's name, but man, that fight scene was so freaking clean. Also, what is her bat made out of? Because it seems to just block literally everything. Even in the fight against Katana later on, she's able to just block a whole blade. It's freaking nuts. Speaking of the fight with Harley and the scientist goes deep into her mind, and we see the origins once again of Harley Quinn, and it shows just like how effed up it was for Joker to do that, to just dump her into a vat of acid to prove her love. Kind of nuts. Granted, Joker, super effed up guy, super crazy. I liked how the scientist kind of got wrapped into that and basically screwed himself over because he couldn't escape that psychological trauma that she went through. So I can only imagine how painful that acid was, let alone the situation of being, hey, it's either you're gonna fall in this and potentially die for me, or he's probably gonna kill her because, you know, she wasn't what she said she was. And once again, it just shows the fact that they're focusing more on Harley in this episode and showing that she's more of a main character. And then we get into the grand finale of this episode, where it's Katana versus Harley Quinn. And for some reason, it's this, the way the fight scene played out in this episode was very similar to how it was in the first one. Their movements were super clunky and slow for the majority of it, especially when the camera was just doing the wide shot, just following them as they were like going around the water. Like, I don't know what it was like, a bit like they put the budget into the scientist fight for sure. But then with this one, it's super slow and clunky. Not really a fan of it. And it's only with Katana and Harley Quinn for some reason. But nevertheless, it showed how cool Katana is. The fact that Clayface turned into a sword. I don't know why. Pure anime vibes, pure awesomeness. Loved it. And I think he was like getting stronger because he was absorbing the clay from the other surfaces as they were like battling, which was smart as frick. And then they defeat her. Honestly, it's just, this episode was just so fun. It was just so fun to watch. Tons of funny moments. If I had to rate the episode, I'd probably give it like, I would have given it a 9, but I'm gonna give it an 8 out of 10 for the fact that, and it's just me, right? This is just me being a nerd. The clunky animation aspect of Harley versus Katana, the slowness unnecessarily, really just killed my momentum a little bit and threw me off. I thought it was just a one and done deal in the first episode, but for some reason it happened again here and I wasn't a fan of it, so that's why I'm giving it an 8 out of 10. But overall, I just love this series. I cannot wait for the next episode. I hope we get more seasons of this because this is just fantastic. And the voice acting, once again, cannot be overstated. It is so good. Again, I'm watching the Japanese dubbed. It is so good. But what did you guys think? Please let me know in the comments below. I'm Captain Zeus, and I'll catch you guys later. See you.